Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be doing my new adult recommendations that I promised you guys. If you haven't watched part one where I kind of explain what new adult is and you're interested in that, I'll leave that down below or I'll have an annotation here on the screen right now. But otherwise, then just keep on watching. So I'm going to start with my 10th favorite to my first all-time favorites. So yeah, I'm just going to get started. I'm also going to be leaving the Goodreads link to every single one of these books in the down bar just in case my explanation of them isn't very good or you want to know more information. So first, I have Reason to Breathe by Rebecca Donovan. This is book one in the Breathing series or the Breathing trilogy, and this book is really, really good. This new adult novel focuses more on the family aspect of growing up and stuff like that and dealing with at-home issues more than romance, but I think there's a little bit of romance sprinkled in on in here too. But I really, really enjoyed this book. It's quite thick, but I finished it easily with no problem. So yeah, this book is really, really good. Number 9 is The Coincidence of Callie and Kayden by Jessica Sorensen. And this one is obviously a love story. This is about two people that are in their first year of college. They were going to high school together, but they didn't really talk much, but they met during the summer. And something kind of extreme happened, and they end up at college together, oddly enough. And they make a connection, and so much stuff. There's a lot of drama in this book. This is actually so far a duology. I think there's going to be another book. But yeah, and it's insane. There's so much going on, but it's really good. It's not like too many plots, but it does have a lot of stuff. Like there's romance, there's issues, there's lots of stuff. And I will tell you though, this ends in a cliffhanger. So be prepared to like have the second book, which also ends in a cliffhanger. So yeah, I don't really know what to tell you about that, but it's still really, really good. Book number 8 is The Edge of Never by J.A. Redmerski. Now, this book is one of my favorites, but I know that it's sort of got some issues. Like, I know that there's people that either really, really like it, or there's people that absolutely hate it. Like, I've recommended it to people before, and they've hated it, but I love it, and I know so many other booktubers that love it, and I don't know, it's kind of interesting. So, I mean, pick it up if you want and see how you like it. This involves a road trip. This girl, Cameron, is just, like, doesn't know what to do with her life. She feels like she's been trapped in the small town, so she wants to get away, so she just buys a bus ticket and takes off, and it ends up being a little road trip between her and this boy named, what's his name? Andrew. Her and Andrew. So it's really interesting. There's a second book as well, so this is a duology, but the first book, it's really, really great. Check out. At number 7, we have Sweet Thing by Renee, Carlino. This is a really, really cute book about this girl that's unsure about what to do with her life. There's a lot of, like, the unsure about what to do with her life. That's sort of a new adult theme. She's kind of unsure about her life, and she's really interested in music, but she has a degree in, like, law or something, a business degree. So she's like, what do I do? Like, I have a business degree. Am I supposed to, like, pursue that? But I'm really interested in music. So she moves to New York when something happens and she's needed there, and she meets this boy on the airplane on the way to New York and stuff happens. That's all I'm gonna say. Number 6 is Slammed by Colleen Hoover. Now, Colleen Hoover is one of my favorite authors, new adult or anything. All of her books are a must-buy, must-read book for me. I'm obsessed with her writing, and this book is very, very good. I really enjoy it. I think a reason that I really, really like it is because it does involve slam poetry, which is one of my favorite things ever, and I talk about my poetry and stuff like that. I do write poetry, I do read poetry, and this book has poetry. Now, if you're not into poetry and you're like, I probably won't like this book, I honestly think you should consider reading it. It's still really good. Even if you don't like slam poetry, you don't think it's something you're interested in, I promise you, you'll probably like this book. It's really, really great. Book number 5 is Bared to You by Sylvia Day, and this is the first in a series of 5 books. Only 3 are currently out, and I love it so much. This book is a little bit more on the sexier side of the new adult books. There's a little bit more sexual content in this book than there is in most new adult books, and this is kind of closer related to adult erotica, but it is still considered like a new adult novel. So just putting that out there, just so you know. But this is about a girl who moves to New York City to work in this office, and it's like the Crossfire buildings, and she meets this guy named Gideon, who happens to own all of this office, and he's really rich, and they meet, and a bunch of stuff happens. Yeah, I really enjoyed this. Number 4, we have Easy by Tammara. This book is amazing. It's about this girl who is in college, and she's at a party one night, and she decides to leave on her own, and she's walking back, and she gets pushed into this car. I think it might even be her car. She gets pushed in by this guy, and he attempts to rape her, but somebody saves her. Somebody pulls him off of her, and, like, makes him leave her alone, and she gets saved by this guy that she doesn't really know, but he ends up being in one of her classes in college, and they make a connection, and stuff happens, obviously, but it's a really, really good book. Great message, great story, and it just keeps you on your feet. At number three, we have another Colleen Hoover book. This is Maybe Someday. It's her most recent release, and it's amazing. It's about this girl, and her name's Sydney, and she is living with her boyfriend and her best friend. They're both her roommates, and they end up having a thing, and she finds out about it, and she's obviously heartbroken because it's her boyfriend who's cheating on her with her best friend. That's crazy, right? So she decides to move out, and she kind of moves in with this guy that she kind of knows sort of a little bit. He lives in the same apartment building, and he invites her to live with her. They haven't really talked before, but they kind of know each other, and he invites her to live there, and stuff happens. And there's a big plot twist in this book that is absolutely phenomenal. I think with a lot of Colleen's books, this one has a huge plot twist that I'm not going to mention. Slammed does too. So is the next book that I'm about to show you. Another Colleen
book. Which is Hopeless by Colleen Hoover. This is my all-time favorite Colleen Hoover book.
Obviously, it's at number two. This book is amazing. It's about this girl named Skye, who is a senior in high school, but all of her life, she's been very guarded off by her mother. Her mother doesn't let her have a cell phone, doesn't let her have an internet connection, doesn't let her have TV. They basically don't have anything. She's been homeschooled her whole life. She only has this one friend named Six who lives next door, and she convinces her mom to let her go to public school for her senior year of high school. And that's basically all I'm going to tell you about this book because I don't want to ruin anything. But yeah, it's really, really good.
The last book I'm about to show you is my all-time favorite new adult novel. It's my favorite. It's always been my favorite. I've read it 5 times. It's my favorite book. It's like my favorite book, okay? I'm obsessed with this book. I'm obsessed with this story. I'm obsessed with these characters. I'm obsessed with their relationship. That is Beautiful Disaster by Jamie McGuire. I'm sure many of you have heard of this or maybe even read it. It's one of the most popular new adult books that I know of, and it's what introduced me to new adult when I first started reading it. It was the first new adult book I ever read, and it's still my favorite. It's about this girl named Abby Abernathy, and she's going into college, and she kind of wants to give herself a new sort of reputation. And she meets this guy named Travis, who is an underground fighter, so he fights illegally and gets money for it. They basically make this bet that if Travis loses his fight, then Abby is gonna make him stay abstinent for a month. But if he wins the fight, she has to live with him for a month. And yeah, that's basically the basis behind the story. But there's so much more than that. Like, that is like this much of the book. And then there's all this other stuff going on. So it's a really great book. It's my love, basically. And I'm obsessed with it. It's just amazing. It's my favorite.
So I'm sorry about this like light. I didn't really realize that was there until now. So I'm sorry if that has been bothersome throughout the video. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful for you if you are interested in exploring the new adult genre and you need recommendations. So if you have any questions about any of these books or anything I've mentioned, let me know down below, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. See you in my next video. Bye.